Hi, this is the first of two presentations addressing the subject of combinational circuit design. At the end, I expect you to be able to explain what is a combinational circuit and why this type of circuits is normally just part of the solution and not an entire solution by itself. I also expect you to be able to list and compare various modeling approaches to combinational circuits. The first part of this presentation explains what is a combinational circuit, and the second part just brings together all the different modeling styles that we have used so far to describe the 2 to 4 decoder function. Let's start then by answering this question. The distinctive feature of combinational circuits is that they are insensitive to what happened in the past. In a combinational circuit, the outputs depend only on the current value of the inputs. In other words, we can say that each input pattern corresponds to only one output pattern. If a circuit is able to store information about past events, then the same input pattern may lead to different output patterns according to what happened before. As it happens in a combinational circuit, since it has no information about the past, each input pattern can only correspond to one output pattern. Notice, however, that the opposite is not true, as proven by the example shown here. Binary multiplication can be done in a strictly combinational manner, and it can be used to show that this type of circuits can range from very simple to fairly complex. This slide shows two off-the-shelf combinational circuit examples from Texas Instruments. On the left, a very simple 2-to-1 multiplexer, and on the right, a historically important circuit, the first complete ALU in a single chip, which is able to perform 16 arithmetic and 16 logic operations on 4-bit operands. The main limitation of combinational circuits is a direct result of their distinctive feature. Most real-world applications need to store information about the past, such as in the case of an electronic lock. For this reason, combinational circuits are normally part of a larger solution, as we will have ample opportunity to see during this course. So let's now revisit the many different coding styles that we have used so far to represent the 2-to-4 decoder, which is a nice introductory example of a combinational circuit. You have already seen all the alternatives that will be considered, but bringing them all together in this presentation offers you a reference document that you can come to whenever you want to consider the options available to create an architectural description. You may recall that we started with a data flow description model when demonstrating the use of Vivado, although we didn't use that name at the time. And here's the generic technology model created by Vivado Synthesis for the data flow description. The second example is the behavioral model using concurrent when-else statements. In this case, we don't say anything about the structure. And we notice that the generic technology model created by Vivado is slightly different, but just slightly if you pay attention. Let's recall now the behavioral model using concurrent with select statements. Again, nothing is said about the structure. And once again, Vivado creates a different technology model representation, generic technology model representation, although the function of the circuit remains exactly the same. Notice also that the estimation of the required number of cells, I/O ports and nets shown on top, varies according to the modeling style used. Let's look now at the use of sequential statements to describe the 2-to-4 decoder. You may recall that this was the nonsense description using sequential signal assignment statements although the concept of sequential execution is meaningless in this case. And consequently, Vivado Synthesis creates exactly the same generic technology model as for the concurrent signal assignment statements used in the dataflow description. We can also use an if statement to build a VHDL description of the 2-to-4 decoder. The conditions presented are evaluated until one is found to be true, and in that case, the corresponding sequence of statements is executed. Notice that this modeling style actually leads to the most complex genetic technology representation at the highest cost estimation of 16 cells. Why do you think this happens? The last sequential statement considered was the case statement. You may still recall that how we used a case statement to model the decoder. This modeling style leads to the same generic technology model as the concurrent with select statement model, and consequently the same cost estimation, which also happens to be the lowest. We shouldn't be surprised due to the similarity of the concurrent with select and the sequential case statements. To conclude, we have the two structural modeling examples, the first of which uses a component declaration. You may recall that we used the 2-to-4 decoder circuit as a lower-level module in a hierarchical representation of the 3-to-8 decoder. And since this is a structural description, Vivado Synthesis is limited in its choices and just replicates the structure that we indicated. Last but not least, let's consider the alternative structural model description. In this case, we used a different method to instantiate the two lower-level decoders, but the generic technology model is the same as we would expect. And that's all for the introduction to combinational circuit design. Thanks for your attention.